Hi, welcome to Classpad.net. In this video, we will explore graphing circles and ellipses. Notice on my text sticky, I have two equations already typed up. The first is that of a circle and the second is that of an ellipse. And I have my graph sticky icon here. Now, before I get started, because we are looking at graphing circles and ellipses, really we're talking about graphing things and looking more at conic sections. So when I click on my graph sticky note, I'm going to go to the settings, which is in the upper right-hand corner. And then the very last thing here is gsolve, and I'm going to click conics. And this will actually turn on all the different items you would typically find when you graph in like a conics app or conics add-in on any graphing calculator, and it'll give you additional information other than, you know, maybe just the center or the x-intercept or the y-intercept. And then I'm also going to change my coordinates to decimal, just because it'll make looking at the numbers just a little bit easier. All right, I'm going to click back over here on my graph. I'm going to click f of x to type in my first function. And let's start with graphing the circle. So I'm going to type x squared plus y squared equals 9. I'm going to keep it simple. I'm going to hit execute. And there you will see is my circle. I don't have to actually convert this to a y equals. I can graph it in that just that standard format, and I could have moved my center a little bit, but I just wanted to keep this one as a simple problem. And as usual, if you are familiar with graphing, if I click on the graph itself and hover over the actual graph of the circle, click on that, you'll notice all those key features pop up. And I can select each one of them. There's a y-intercept, here's an x-intercept, and move that decimal or move that coordinate so that I can see everything a little bit better. And then also click on my radius and my center. And there are all my key features of that circle. And then I can also use those, you know, I can take r and use that in another equation if I wanted to, but I get that's, you know, the basics of everything that you want to see. All right, moving on, I'm going to actually open up another graph sticky and just kind of scroll down a little bit. Move that down here a bit and open up another graph sticky. And graph my ellipse now. Make the screen a little bit bigger. So click on f of x. And you'll notice that because I have two different graph stickies open, the second graph does graph in red. So instead of retyping everything, I'm going to just highlight this and see if this works. Use my keyboard shortcuts to copy and paste. And there is my ellipse. Now, I'm going to double check because this is a brand new sticky note page. I probably did not change anything like I did in the previous one. So once again, I'm going to change that to decimal and click on conics. So now that when I hover over the ellipse, all those fun key features show up. You have your eccentricity already given to you. There is your one of your foci and your vertex. All those key information, key pieces of information are there. I can move this over just a bit so that gives me a little bit more room so I can move things around a little bit more. You know, at my center there. And there are all my key features. So I have my focus or my foci, my vertex, the center, the x and y intercepts, and my eccentricity all displaying at the same time. So that's just a basics on getting graphing circles and ellipses and taking a look at their, you know, key features using conics. For more classpad.net tips, feel free to subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.